Last class we studied about karma yoga. My dear students, today we are going to continue that. I was telling about you in the last class about work. Work is not only work. Work is action, product, effect. So karma yoga teaches how to act. Many majority of the people, we don't know how to act only. We act with a lot of tension. So karma yoga clearly says action without expecting the fruits. Perform action with detachment, and that action is called selfless action. Majority of the people who work for selfish life become nonsense, stress related problems. We are seeing, we are seeing in our Nature Cure Hospital, SDM Nature Cure Hospital, patient comes with a lot of tensions, hypertension, diabetes and different diseases. When as their work pattern, a lot of tension, no, without lot of expectations. This leads to later their life become nonsense and we are becoming diseased person. That's why karma yoga teaches selfless action. Action, that's why clearly Krishna says to Arjuna, karmanyevadhikarasye ma phaleshu kadachana, ma karma phalahetuurbhu, ma te sangostva karmani. Work for the work's sake. Don't expect the fruits. Leave the fruits to me, Arjuna. Then automatically you'll be detached. You come up. The moment Bhagavad Gita entirely was preached by Krishna to Arjuna, Arjuna was ready for war. That is his duty. So goal of karma yoga is to finally the balanced state of the mind. If you attachment, imbalanced state of the mind. If you are detached in your work, balanced state of the mind. Balance for all pleasure and pain, happiness and sorrow. Same equama state. That's why samatvam yoga uchyate. Bhagavad Gita says about samatva, equanimity state of mind. So that's why yoga is very beautiful, effective in this. So what are the different karmas we do? Sakamya karma. Work with expectation. With a lot of expectation. I want this. Nishkamya karma. Without expectation. So karma yoga aims at nishkamya karma. Not sakamya or kamya. Without any purpose. If you do any action with a purpose, attachment comes. If you are doing any action without any expecting the fruits, detachment results. So that's why sakamya karma. I alluded to action with purpose behind it. Nishkamya karma without expecting fruits of it. And karma yoga aims at it. So that's why these all the very important aspects of karma yoga. That's why in karma yoga beautifully says, who is the ideal karma yogi? Swami Vivekananda rightly said, Buddha is the ideal karma yogi. He saw the great word, what you practice, you preach. What you practice, you preach. What you preach, you practice. So that's why yes, beautifully Swami Vivekananda said these two great words in related to karma yoga. And Buddha says, very good, do good and be good. That only take you to high. Don't expect the fruits, do good and be good. So liberation from the bondages of birth and death is the aim of karma yoga, and reference we get in Bhagavad Gita. So next comes is about bhakti yoga. What is bhakti? Beautifully Narada says about bhakti, Narada Bhakti Sutras, Swatvasmin Parama Prema Rupaha, intense love towards God, supreme love towards God. That is very important. Prema Rupaha, Parama Prema, supreme love. No expectation is love. Normally we understood love, again kamya love, with expectation. That is not called as prema, it is called as kama, lust, greed. So it is not like that. But bhakti is supreme love towards God. Narada Bhakti Sutras, you can beautifully says, Chandilya and other great, because Bhakta Prahalada is the best example for bhakti. Mirabai, they are the best bhakti yogis, great bhakti yogis. So the supreme love towards God, according to Chandilya, intense attachment to God, bhakti is, it is attachment to the God. That attachment is not detached attachment, it's not expectation, no expectation here, totally one with the God. So what are the fruits of bhakti yoga? So Narada beautifully says, yallabdopaman siddho bhavati, amrutho bhavati, tripto bhavati. So first is siddho bhavati, we become perfect by God realization. Then amrutho bhavati, there is no death for a bhakta. He is ever living in the presence of God. Immortality, satisfied. His all desires are gratified by God realization. So that is why it is called as tripto bhavati. No tripti in him. Normally when we have an object, we want one object, again we want another object. That is not called tripti. We are not satisfied. We are craving more and more. But after the surrender to God, after all his bhakti margas, he will be perfectly satisfied. There is no desire in him. Because his all desires are quenched by the immortal nectar of God realization. So that's why the fruits of bhaktis are immortality, perfect and satisfied. What is the purpose of bhakti yoga? It's very important, God realization. But commonly how can we use? We can use in the form of emotional culture. We all know about it, that we are in our entire education system, there is no role for emotions balance. Bhakti is the best way. By one parama prema rupaha, by one love towards Almighty, we can burn all kama, krodha, moha, lobha, madha, matsaryas. So we can get an emotional balance and slowing down our emotions. So that's why Bhakti Yoga beautifully explains in modern world, Bhakti is the best way to balance our emotions. We have two options, either we have to express our emotion or we have to suppress our emotions. Expressing is dangerous. In Western countries, you know, they started expressing social evil activities happened there. So that's why they stopped doing that. Okay, expression leads to many problems. Suppression, psychosomatic elements, and then drug addictions, and suicide, and so on and so forth. So that's why they stopped. Okay, suppression is also not good. Expression is not. Best way is sublimation. Sublimation means slowing down our emotions. You know, when you are driving a vehicle, you are driving at 100 kilometer per hour. You will be into 80, 60, 40, and then you stop, 20. Suddenly you stop, what happens? There's a jerk in the vehicle. Similarly, suppressing is also dangerous. Express sublimation in Bhakti Yoga by complete love towards God, by repeating the Navavidha Bhaktis. Next we are going to study about it. We are sublimating and slowing down our emotions. When we slow down, automatically our emotions are under very good control. So that's why Bhakti teaches this. There are three means of Bhakti. What are they? Pratika, by symbol of God. Repeating the Om, we are nearing to God, symbol of God. Pratima, statue of the God. We are surrendering to the statue of God. Repeating the name of the God, Nama, we can go nearer and nearer with the intense love towards God. So the classification of Bhakti, you can see there, Apara Bhakti and Parabhakti. Apara Bhakti is a preparatory practices. Mukhya Bhakti, there, Mukhya Bhakti, we practice now, later we study about it, Navavidha Bhaktis and qualities, requisites and all those things. And Gauni Bhakti, maybe at when you are moving in the Apara Bhakti, we may take a wrong direction. That is, intense attachment can lead to, again, loving our idol, hating other idol. Loving our religion, hating, it's not Bhakti called as. So you should not go to Gauni Bhakti, Mukhya Bhakti only you have to go, and you should reach to Parabhakti, post-realization state. Post-realization, you are realizing the God. Just now I told immortality, perfection, Siddho Bhavati, Tripto Bhavati, satisfied. So that's why, here, the Mukhya Bhakti, what are the practices? Practicing of Navavidha Bhaktis. Sri Narada beautifully explains, Shravana, listening the glory of Lord. Then Kirtana, repeating His name, reciting His name. Then Smarana, remembering the God. You can see there the beautiful picture of how we remember the God. It's a form of Bhakti. Dasya, total surrender to God. See, when we become devote, servant to the Lord, our all egos comes down. Which obstacle has to in the life? Not to proceed is our ego. So Bhakti, above than me there is a God. I am surrendered to His lotus feet. Dasya and Sakya, friendship. You can see in Krishna all His friends were. That is also a form of Bhakti. Sakya, friendship with the Lord. Pada Sevana, serving the lotus feet of Lord. Again, it is also a very important form of Bhakti, because this all removes our egos and we are becoming one with the God. So Archana, worshipping the Lord. Worshipping is also a form of Bhakti. Maybe we are taking one parshim. There are 16 forms of pujas are there. 16 steps are there in puja. Archana, worshipping the Lord. Vandana, saluting to Lord. The total surrender to Lord. Totally we are saluting to the Lord. So our Atma and Paramatma becomes one. The solution, if you are saluting one, that means we are saluting not to the person. So with this, we are stopping today, because we are continuing this Bhakti Yoga in the next class.